Hey guys, my name is Grandy over here. Please add me all of my content and subscribe on my YouTube channel. Let's begin. In this video, we're going to talk about four topics:
the golden age, the government structure, and the wise guy economy, then roleplay, and the last one, the brotherhood code.
So what is the wise guy community? Well, the wise guy community fit under a category of a mafia group, which is all about roleplaying, where players get to build rooms that resemble casinos, strip clubs, and secret rooms, where players get to dress like Italian mafias. Although the wise guy community is part of a role-playing community, the wise guy community don't see themselves as a role-playing community, but more or less see themselves as brothers. The wise guy community was founded in 2018 during the middle age of Hotel Hideaway popularity. At the time, Hotel Hideaway was working with the game Pablo to attract more players from Pablo to Hotel Hideaway. Hotel Hideaway teams use exclusive items like the duck, t-shirts, and the iconic paper bag to attract more players from the game Pablo, and this plan was actually successful in attracting many Pablo players to Hotel Hideaway, who began to build their own community. One of the successful club owners in Hotel Hideaway at the time was Flinch Wellington, who started to build his own community, which eventually became known as a role-playing mafia community. Flinch Wellington began to select his loyal friends, named Bush and Inner, Ben H, Vito, Lucky, Jeff, Joe Shoshut, and James. All of them contributed to the wise guy community, and together they built the wise guy community, which later on into the video I will be explaining in depth on what they contributed to the wise guy community. The golden age of the wise guy community. Around 2020, the wise guy community gained over 300 members in their community, which was quite of a large number when compared to Hotel Hideaway communities. They also expanded their influence from four different servers, such as English servers, Spanish servers, French servers, and even Dutch servers. So how did the wise guy community stretch its own community all over Hotel Hideaway servers? And how were they able to manage to control their whole entire community? While behind the scenes, Flinch Wellington started building their own Discord community with over 30 members that were seen as loyal to the community. And from those 30 members, they created James policy that would not only just help the wise guy community, but would guide their community to a greater path. They create policies like the Union Alliance, the Union Taxes, the Moving Forward Act, the Wise Guy Protection, the Brotherhood Code, the Open Door Policy, and even sexual harassment campaigns. All these policies are what made the wise guy community to become a superpower community. But for now, we are just going to stick with the two policies, which were heavy influenced by the wise guy community in the golden age: the wise guy protection and the moving forward act policy. The moving forward policy was created by Flinch Wellington and Joey Shoshut and other high-profile members of the wise guy community. It was not a law, but more of a philosophy that aims to promote knowledge sharing and the establishment of communities across different servers and Hotel Hideaway. The philosophy was certain around the idea that the wise guy community was superior to other communities in Hotel Hideaway. The wise guy community believed that they were the best at everything in their community. They believed that they were experts in creating laws, policies, government structure, role-playing, and even their own philosophy. This sense of superiority and confidence in their own ability led them to create the moving forward policy. However, the main idea of the moving forward policy was to share their knowledge and spread their influence across different servers to establish communities. The wise guy community implemented a policy called the wise guy protection in order to exert control over Hotel Hideaway rooms. This policy offers protection to clubbish rooms such as bars and clubs by preventing trolls and negative players from getting access to published rooms. However, in reality, it serves as a means of dominance by the wise guy community. The wise guy community utilized three warning strikes from the Brotherhood Code Law to enforce their policy. The first warning is a verbal warning to stop causing problems in published rooms, and if a player persists in the same behavior that the community dislike, then they will receive a second strike and will be placed on a rosters of bad list of bad players, effectively blocking them from clubs and bars.
Congress. The third strike was considered the final straw, and it was ruthless and unforgivable measures. In this case, the player Google account, Facebook account, along with their address and phone number and their last name will be tracked down by the Wise Guy community. The use of the three warning strikes policy by the Wise Guy community has been a source of controversy within the community. Many players have expressed concerns over the ability to obtain personal information on players. The amount in which the Wise Guy community was able to access this information remained unclear, and it has been viewed as creepy and insane by many players' concerns. Despite these concerns, the policy remains ineffectively, and it has been used continuously to stop players from causing problems. Anyway, let's get back to what we were saying about the Wise Guy protection policy. To become a member of the Wise Guy protection policy, you must be a room owner who either builds a community or join one that is associated with the Union Alliance. A room owner must pay their loyalty in order to be part of the Wise Guy protection, which comes in the forms of cookies, which I think that's adorable. As part of the Wise Guy protection policy, Wise Guy members would visit club rooms that were under their protection at the end of each month to collect the shares of profit, which were typically in the forms of cookies. If the room owner fails to pay the Wise Guy community, then members of the Wise Guy community would cause problems in the room owner rooms, potentially leading to negative views on those rooms that didn't pay. It was crucial for room owners to apply with the payment terms set out by the Wise Guy protection policy,
as failure to do so could result in the removal from the Wise Guy protection and will be kicked out from the Union Alliance. These two policies are what made the Wise Guy community reach out throughout the Golden Age because of the two policy impact and influence on Hotel Hideaway. The Wise Guy community had gained a lot of members and room owners that wanted to join the Wise Guy community.
Within 4 years, the Wise Guy community was able to expand their influence and become an empire slash role-playing community.
One of the Wise Guy community high-ranking members named Bishop Inner said in his own words that the Wise Guy community grew to be a respected and feared group of active trolls slash role-playing communities.
But sadly, the Golden Age was coming to an end. Soon after, Hotel Hideaway staff saw the Wise Guy community as a threat. And as conflict between Flinch Mountain and Hotel Hideaway staff worsened, members of the Wise Guy community said Flinch Wellington was becoming too personal with Hotel Hideaway staff. As a result, he was permanently banned from Hotel Hideaway by Ryan, leading Flinch Wellington to pass on his leadership to his loyal friend named Joey Shotcher to rule the Wise Guy community.
Joey Shotcher, now being the leader of the Wise Guy community, had a clear objective goal of gaining the trust and support of high-ranking members within the community. He believed that by establishing strong relationship with high-ranking members, he can consolidate his control on the Wise Guy community. However, the departure of several Union Alliance members, particularly those who were part of the Union Alliance community connected to Flinch Wellington, began to leave the Union Alliance. This caused the Union Alliance community to weaken the Union Alliance and likely diminished Joey Shotcher's influence within the Union Alliance. To counter this setback, Joey Shotcher implemented a new policy called the Open Door Policy. This policy aims to support any community that wished to join the Union Alliance. By adopting an open approach, Joey Shotcher hoped to attract new community to the Union Alliance, thereby
compensating
for the loss of departure members and boosting his positions within his community. The Open Door Policy
essentially meant
that any community interested and join the Union Alliance would receive support and assistance. This support
could come
in form of resources, guidelines, or any necessary aid to help the Union Alliance communities to integrate into the Union Alliance. Despite Joey Shotcher's influence to make players feel comfortable and welcome within the Union Alliance, some of the older members, high-ranking members of the Wise Guy community, still criticize him for his actions, specifically demonize him for allowing other communities to join the Union Alliance without any background check, which is mandated by the Brotherhood Code Law. According to the Brotherhood Code Law, any community seeks to join the Union Alliance must go through under background check. However, when Joey Shotcher was in the leadership, he did not enforce this requirement and allow other communities to join without conducting through background check. Joey Shotcher believed that he was doing the right thing by allowing the entrance of many communities into the Union Alliance. He saw it as a way to compensate for the loss of other communities that had left when Flinch Wellington was banned. In his mind, helping these communities join was a means of rebuilding and strengthening the Union Alliance.
But later on, the open door policy that Joe Judges created will later hurt him in the back. The separation of the wise guy community. Now, I didn't include this in the topic list at the beginning of the video, but the separation of the wise guy community is the decline of the golden age and division between wise guy community. Flinch Wellington will make a return under a new username named Marco Wellington while Joey Chachas was ruling the wise guy community as the leader. Marco Wellington didn't like his friend Joey Chachas' open door policy, believing that will loosen the wise guy community's security. This conflict about the open door policy between Joey Chachas and Marco Wellington caused the wise guy community to turn into two factions of the wise guy community. One led by Joey Chachas, the current leader of the wise guy community, and the other one led by Marco Wellington, a former leader of the wise guy community and the founding father of the wise guy community. The two factions of the wise guy community decided to engage into non-violent civil war because, according to the Brotherhood code law, brothers don't fight or betray one another, saying that we are one brother and one community. So instead of turning to violence between the two communities that represent the wise guy community, members of the two communities should vote based on the two community leaders. Whoever won the election based on the numbers of votes would be the leader of the wise guy community. Now let's explain each faction in the wise guy community, starting off with Joey Chachas' faction. Joey Chachas' factions in the wise guy community believe that the open door policy led the alliance to grow in numbers, which helped the wise guy community and colony to grow. As well, the open door policy built insurance that the wise guy community is protected by the alliance. So members of the Joey Chachas' factions felt like Joey Chachas should have won the election to become the leader of the wise guy community, while Marco Wellington / Flush Wellington factions of the wise guy community consider French Wellington as an ideal person to manage the wise guy community. Older members of the wise guy community believe that French Wellington should become the leader once again. They highlight that his fact that his charisma and his charm makes players feel at ease. They also saw French Wellington as more than a simple leader, but as a demigod to the community. At the time, wise guy older members believed that without French Wellington as the leader, the wise guy community would collapse. While this whole non-violent civil war was going on, in the year line, the Ross grand family was having their own issues in their community, with Taylor Ross having a fallout with his second admin leader. So the issue between the second admin leader and Taylor Ross was that Taylor Ross was using his fame of being friends of the wise guy community to somehow obtain young females' pictures, despite the fact that his age is 35. This is simply just an allegation, but the second admin leader was shocked learning about this discovery, as well finding out that Taylor Ross was dating a minor while she was only just 16. Like I said before, this is just an allegation, but this allegation hurt Taylor Ross' reputation as the leader of the Ross crime family and affected his relationship with his second admin leader. Eventually, the second admin leader informs every member of the Ross crime family about his allegations, leading many victims to open up about Taylor Ross taking advantage of his positions to abuse them. Eventually, Taylor Ross was kicked out from his Discord group after the second admin leader uses those allegations to report him on Discord. The second admin leader takes the leadership of the Ross crime family from the abuser, resulting in a coup against the leader. Taylor Ross was not so happy about his removal from the Ross crime family that he created. So Taylor Ross then went to his college friend named Alex Maradonka about the situation. And their conversation really interesting between Alex Maradonka and Taylor Ross. Now, I don't know exactly what happened between Alex Maradonka and Taylor Ross, but luckily I asked one of the U-Line's older members for more content between Alex Maradonka and Taylor Ross conversations. And they didn't give me any screenshots, but they told me what exactly happened to Taylor Ross and Alex Maradonka. Somehow, Alex Maradonka already knew about Taylor Ross' allegations. And before Taylor Ross went to Alex Maradonka unfriended Taylor Ross from his friend group and banned the Ross crime family from the alliance. This was another W move for the Westgate community, but in reality, no one in the Westgate community didn't know what was going on in the Taylor Ross crime family. In fact, the Westgate community didn't have no idea that the Ross crime family was part of the alliance because of the open door policy having a loop. And this is the reason why Marco Wellington was trying to prevent the open door policy, because he viewed as a straightforward way for an enemy to attack the wise guy community, leaving the wise guy community vulnerable. As well, Marco Wellington saw the open door policy as a way for communities to come and go as they please without no background checks. Taylor Ross felt betrayed that the wise guy community cut him off. Members of the alliance that used to be his friend claims that Taylor Ross plotted against the wise guy community for a sick man of revenge. Anyway, the division of the wise guy community almost came to an end when two factions of the wise guy community realized that Mark Wanted cannot be leader of the wise guy community. Even though he is the founding father of the wise guy community, Mark Wanted did not realize that the Brotherhood Code that he created quotes that in the Brotherhood Code law state that for one to be a leader must be in level 50, and Mark Wanted was not in level 50 yet. But before the vote came to pass, both Jewish Chargers and Mark Wanted were suddenly banned, which was insane that both players at the same time got banned. Now, there's two theories on the banning of both leaders of the Wise Guy community. The first theory from the Wise Guy community itself saying that Hotel Hideaway banned both leaders because they saw the Wise Guy community as a threat to Hotel Hideaway, and they weren't a big fan of Mark Wanted. But still, that doesn't give them the right to ban Jewish Chargers. Like, that's kind of weird and suspicious. The second theory, however, makes sense to me, is that Taylor Ross was involved in the banning of Jewish Chargers and Mark Wanted because he was close to Alex Marinanko and was the member of the alliance. As I mentioned before, Taylor Ross was upset that Alex Marinanko unfriended him, and he was not pleased when Alex Marinanko banned him from the alliance. And this really makes sense. He was really mad, and since he was part of the alliance, he did knew that Mark Wanted is from Wanted. Taylor Ross was for sure working with Hotel Hideaway staff, which they also wanted the removal of the Wise Guy community. So both of Hotel Hideaway staff and Taylor Ross had the same goal. When Taylor Ross told Hotel Hideaway staff that Mark Wanted is from Wanted, Hotel Hideaway staff was freaking out when they find out that Flinch Wellington was back, causing Hotel Hideaway staff to ban both leaders of the Wise Guy community. But at the end of the day, these theories really doesn't matter to Taylor Ross because he really didn't gain anything from the banning of both leaders. But later on, this would backfire on him when Hotel Hideaway staff learned that Taylor Ross had a history of pedophile behavior that include dating young girls and asking them for their images, leading to the end of Taylor Ross getting banned by the Hotel Hideaway staff that he once worked with. After the banning of both leaders from the Wise Guy community, at some point in time, Vito take over the Wise Guy community. Although he wasn't mentioned a lot in the Wise Guy community, he was just a replacement for Joey Chargers.
However, Vito passed down his power to Ben Hage to rule the Wise Guy community.
Then, Ben Hage, as leader, chose Vito to become his vice president of the alliance. The Wise Guy community considered that Ben Hage was the right man to rule the Wise Guy community, putting up the fact that Ben Hage is outspoken when it comes to community problems. As well, Ben Hage is also a close friend to Joey Chargers and Flinch Wellington, watching his two friends being banned, making a strong leader. Bushwick, in other words, quote that since then, Ben Hage has taken a role of the boss and leading the Wise Guy community down a path of success and virtue, a new age of peace. But it doesn't just end there. Ben Hage has some college work in his personal life, so he stepped down and passed his power to Lucky, also his friend,
and the current leader of the Wise Guy community.
The next topic is the government structure and the Wise Guy economy. Let's begin. Now, in the Golden Age and the Separation Age, I did a little bit mention the alliance in the video, but I didn't explain it because we're not in the Wise Guy government structure topic yet. But now we are in the topic, we can talk about the alliance policy more in depth. Then after that, we could explain the Wise Guy community pyramids, government structure, as well the Wise Guy community economy in all together. The alliance policy is a form of authoritarian government. So what is an authoritarian government? Authoritarian government doesn't seek control of culture, media, or education, and society itself, unless that does pose a threat to their government, meaning that the Wise Guy community don't like to get involved in the alliance community. But that doesn't mean they don't have influence in the alliance, because the community that wanted to join the alliance community must go through background checks, which is a form of surveillance by the Wise Guy community. So that means they have influence on any community that joins. As well, the Wise Guy community give the alliance community more freedom to do basically whatever they want in their community, but must follow the Brotherhood Code and pay their alliance taxes. The Wise Guy community is also seen as a federal government system based on the fact they're mostly dependent on the alliance to protect their community from attackers. And the meaning of a federal government is to control territories or state by federal law. For example, just like Russia. Inside the Russian Federation, the Russian Federation owns territories like the Republic of Sakha. The people of Sakhan have their own laws and traditional customs, ruled in the Republic of Sakhan, but must follow the Russian Federation law. Similar to the Wise Guy community government, the Wise Guy community has many communities inside the EU lines. For those that don't understand Russian history and its geography, we can use another example. In the United States, America has two systems, the state law and the United States federal law. Each of the community in the EU lines are just like states in the United States, and each state has their own different law depending on where you live. While the Wise Guy community is based on the federal law, which many EU lines community must follow the federal law, just like United States. The EU lines can be found on the Wise Guy Discord, created by the Wise Guy community that allow other communities to join in the alliance. Whether if it is a small community, big community, the Wise Guy community doesn't care as long as they have a leader. The Wise Guy community would offer them protections from their enemy and other rival communities.
The alliance has 11 mafia groups in total, starting off with
the LaRocca crime family. Jada formed the LaRocca crime family, which has over around 19 members on Hotel Hideaway and 26 members on Discord. In our community, Jada is known as the unbreakable force. This indicates that always overcome and wins when facing attacks or challenges, which is quite fascinating about her.
The Mina family was founded by Enigma of Paradox, has over 4 Hotel Hideaway members, and on Discord has 52 members. Enigma of Paradox is known as a wise guy pet, which I think is funny because Enigma of Paradox doesn't pay Indian taxes at all and somehow get away with it without being yelled at. Some of the Union Line members build theories on how he gets away without paying his Union Line taxes, claiming that Enigma of Paradox has a biological father in the Wise Guy community. Fun fact, Enigma of Paradox is the only person in the Union Line who joined the Wise Guy Academy as a shot caller before he becomes the leader of Mina family, the Morningstar. The Morningstar community was founded by Omega Morningstar. The Morningstar community has over 27 members on Hotel Hideaway, and on Discord is unknown. The Morningstar community is quite controversial within the Union Lines because of the fact that they don't get along with the Wise Guy community. Some of the Wise Guy community members dislike the Morningstars and claim that the Morningstar community is trying to destroy the Wise Guy community from the inside, claiming that's the reason why they joined the Union Lines. While the Morningstar community members dislike the Wise Guy community because of the fact that the Wise Guy community keep on interfering in their community. So both communities are like divorced couples. Anyway, Raven MC. The Raven MC, founded by Sam Ace. Sam Ace has over 3 members on Hotel Hideaway, and on Discord is unknown. The Raven MC community is way different from other role-playing mafia community. The Raven MC community call themselves biker riders, which is part of their role-play.
The Bertinelli community. The Bertinelli community was founded by Kane Bertinelli. Kane Bertinelli has over 30 members in Hotel Hideaway and 300 members on Discord. Kane Bertinelli is a close friend of Jada, and when I was in his club, he introduced me to Jada. Kane Bertinelli is quite known for being a room owner in the community, also is known as a Capion member of the Wise Guy community. He's also known for designing elaborate clubs, parties, and ballrooms. The Genevieve crime family. The Genevieve crime family was founded by Elder Structo. Oh my gosh, what's with these names? Anyway, Elder Structo has over 26 members on Hotel Hideaway, and on Discord, 200 members on his Discord. Elder Structo is friends with Sam Ace and has the impressive ability to speak 2 languages, which is truly amazing. Hyena Server CEO. Hyena Server CEO was founded by Bleach Goblin and has over 40 members on Hotel Hideaway as well, but 30 members on Discord. Hyena Server CEO community was more of a network than a role-playing community. Bleach Goblin built her community based on helping the Wise Guy community security. The HH Warrior community. The HH Warrior community was founded by Jade Warrior, has over 28 members on Hotel Hideaway, and on Discord has around 200. The HH Warrior community is different because it's not based on Mafia, but more of a superhero role-playing community. Next up,
The Salamanca Cartel was founded by Don Hector and has over 23 members on the Hotel Hideaway. And on Discord, the number is quite unknown, but some say it's up to 40 or 30. The Salamanca Cartel is similar to Mafia role-playing community, but the only difference is that it's more of a cartel role-playing community, like role-playing on selling illegal substances. The Casasella Crime Family. The Casasella Crime Family was founded by Vera Maria as well, had over 30 members on the Hotel Hideaway, and on Discord, the same 30 members on Discord. Used to work with the Salamanca Cartel before she decided to make her community. When I first met her, she was the one that introduced me to Don Hector at the Jewish Festival Club. I heard from Vera Maria that she has stepped down as the leader, passing her leadership to her friend. The Rex Bird German Dogs. Quinn Lowelzy, the founder of the Rex German Dogs, is a new member of the Alliance. Thereby, his old highway and Discord community numbers are unknown, but the community is built on a team of Native American cowboys.
So all of these communities are part of the Alliance. This really shows how dominant the Wise Guy community are, and it's really impressive. But for now, let's get into the Wise Guy community governance system. So in the Wise Guy community, everyone has their own class and skills based on their profession. So everyone hang on tight and let's begin. Starting off with the beginner level of the Wise Guy community pyramid.
The Wise Guy Academy. The importance of the Wise Guy Academy is where everything all begins. The Wise Guy Academy was made by Finch Wellington. His goal was to teach newcomers about the Wise Guy community history. The Wise Guy Academy is a resource of knowledge, and to become a Wise Guy member, you must go through the Wise Guy Academy, where you get to be tested based on your knowledge of the Wise Guy community.
Associates.
After you pass the Wise Guy Academy, you then become an associate, meaning a regular member of the community. But even though you are a regular member of the Wise Guy community, you are still not part of the Wise Guy community because of the lack of trust issues. The Wise Guy community over the years has been betrayed many times, so they don't really trust newcomers, but they still would see you as a student of the Wise Guy community. So just remember, everyone, that associates are students of the Wise Guy community and they are not included in the community.
Muscles. Muscles are members of the Wise Guy community, but to become a muscle, you need to take your first covenant allegiance to the community. Now, this is when you are fully part of the Wise Guy community. So the allegiance is like a Wise Guy tradition, in which they all gather in a circle and one person must be in the middle of the circle. After that, they would call their names of the person in the middle of the circle as a celebration of welcoming into the brotherhood. Once you fully become a muscle, then your job is to go to room owners who are in the Wise Guy protection and ask them to pay their taxes. A capio is a businessman and a head of three branches from the Wise Guy Academy, Associate, and the Muscles. Capio members had important assets of the Wise Guy community. They are known to own multiple clubs in Hotel Hideaway, make special events for arranging weddings and parties, as well known for working with room owners in the Wise Guy protection. Some of the room owners begged to become friends with a capio member, thinking that they would get away with not paying their union taxes. But it's not easy becoming a capio member, because a capio member called WETBS, which is a standard for Wise Guy economy test based statistic. Now the statistics that they're taking is way much easier than what I took in college, but the statistics that they are taking are basically
basic math graph. And the reason why capio members take the WETBS test is to gain basic knowledge of the Wise Guy economy. And it's funny that the Wise Guy economy is based on just cookie. Shot callers. Shot caller members are like securities or spies, and to become a shot caller member, you must make another covenant. Now, I don't know much about being a shot caller because the Wise Guy community didn't give me much details on being a shot caller. But all I know that shot caller members are very secretive on choosing players to become a shot caller. And shot callers are known to get what they want from a person. Like for example, if you don't pay your union taxes, just pray to God they don't find out, because when they do find out, you would be added on the rosters in the Three Brotherhood Code. Shot callers members' jobs is to see who joins in the new alliance and to protect the Wise Guy community. Outside of the Wise Guy community, shot callers are known to be ruthless and know how to handle unloyal members, trolls, and pedophiles. In fact, Chuck Holler members are the ones who made policies on anti-sexual harassment campaigns, crack it down anyone in the clubs, bars, and even their own members, and if they're found proven, they will be added on the roster of pedophiles on the Good Brotherhood Code. This policy was to protect their female players from being harassed by pedophiles.
Advisor members are known to be retired members of the Wise Guy community. Now, I have no idea why they are in the third level, but anyway, advisor members are Lynch Wellington, Joey Shotridge, James, Vito, and Ben. They are considered to be advisor members. Now, that doesn't mean that they are completely retired, because they can come back again and run as leader again, like what Lynch Wellington did. But anyway, advisors are seen as founding fathers.
Moving on to the underboss. Underboss is a definition of a second leader. Now, the founding fathers of the Wise Guy community created a second leader because they were afraid that if one leader controlled the whole entire community, then they would turn into a tyrant and a bully, which the founding fathers didn't want to give one leader absolute power of control. So they divided the power, which they called the underboss. Underboss controls the Wise Guy community Discord and the Alliance, while the first leader, which is called Boss, controls the community on the Hotel Hideaway and the Alliance too. The boss slash leader. Being the boss in the Wise Guy community is extremely difficult because everyone is dependent on you on the Alliance. Everyone is also expecting you to be perfect in every way, but luckily boss have underboss that can guide you as a friend, and shop callers that can give you advice when things are not going the right way in the community. Also, in order to be a leader, you must be a level 50, and you had to be a shop caller first before becoming a leader. So most leaders were shop callers before becoming a leader.
The founding father. The Wise Guy community founding father is Lynch Wellington. People in the community really admire him and see him as a demigod. He is known to be very kind and loyal to his friends. Lynch Wellington created community just for his friends, never expecting it to become so popular in Hotel Hideaway. His legacy as the founding father will never be forgotten because of the significant impact he had on the community. The way the community respect him and honor him is truly fascinating, as they see him as a great father figure to everyone in the Wise Guy community. Anyway guys, we did go over the Wise Guy community, different levels on a pyramid scale, but now the next topic is the Wise Guy economy.
The Wise Guy economy. Money represents wealth, power, and riches in real life, just like cookies on Hotel Hideaway. And generally, cookies represent status because they are the equivalent of money. The more you have, the more players will think you are unique or a huge member of the community. Cookies also indicate your level of influence and the numbers of friends or connections you have. Additionally, it demonstrates that you are a veteran player.
The Wise Guy community values cookies not just as money, but as an central part of their gaming culture. Capital members hold the community economy, relying on union taxes to boost it. The Alliance leaders pay union taxes to be part of the Alliance. Overall, the Wise Guy community is very generous on assisting other communities and supporting struggle room owners.
Please like to subscribe to my video, and don't forget to follow me on all of my social media accounts, including my new World Road Instagram account. Thank you guys for supporting me, and goodbye.